An exploration of Grace Nichols' resentment. The Atlantic slave trade began in the 16th century and was abolished in the British Empire in the early 19th century. During four centuries, American and European nations obtained enslaved people from African slave traders, although some were captured by European slave traders. Born in Guyana in 1950, author and poet Grace Nichols moved into England in 1977, where she has compiled several books of poetry, many of which discuss the slave trade. Her poem Taint is an illustration of her resentment of the legacy of the slave trade. The title of the poem itself is significant, a one emotive word impact, taint, which means spoil, stain or tarnish, a negative word that introduces the reader to what's to come. Would also argue that the layout of the poem complements this notion. The layout is effectively disorganized with stanzas and lines of different sizes, which can be qualified as visually unsightly. Her first stanza begins with the word but, which would usually imply a response to an ongoing conversation, but the rest of the sentence gives the impression the author is making a plea, but was stolen by men. Believe the use of the pronoun at the first person signifies that, however, Grace Nichols hasn't lived the experience narrated in the poem. She adopts the persona of her ancestors as if it did happen to her. The first person will be consistently used throughout the poem and contribute in making the reading slash experience much more personal. With the use of strong emotive vocabulary such as stolen, I believe Grace Nichols wants to show the reader how she felt like a possession. The use of stolen rather than kidnapped in humanness and the use of passive tense indicates that it was against her will. She was stolen, things were being done to her and she was not in control. All of which contribute to convey a feeling of defensiveness. Making a pause, a one-line gap, she then goes on to say, "The color of my own skin." The phrase doesn't start with a capital, which suggests a continuation of the previous sentence. The pause is giving a dramatic oral effect, as if the author couldn't write them down or say these words straight away, horrified of the cruel truth they hold. I believe that, through this pause, Grace Nichols wanted to show her resentment at the betrayal of black slave traders that ruled the slave trade for centuries, delivering black slaves, slaves of the same color that of their own, to white merchants. The author reinforces the idea of helplessness when she describes herself as being borne away apostrophe dot by means of metaphors and animal imagery. Grace Nichols appears to be comparing these men to the devil itself. She refers to them as men with hoofs and talons, features usually associated with the devil. Meanwhile, it is possible that the use of verbs such as had become and had turned are highlighting her belief that these men went through a transformation, and we could recognize that it is their actions that turned them into devil-like creatures. The last three lines of this stanza are interesting both for their vocabulary and their structure, bearing me down slash to the trail of darkness. Here I believe the author wanted to show that she was held against her will and going to a place she didn't want to go, and the use of vocabulary such as darkness seems to indicate the mood of the poem. The lines are becoming shorter and it seems as if it illustrates her state of mind at that moment, low, lower, lowest in the darkness. In the next stanza, the phrase "the color of my own skin," used earlier on, is being repeated to emphasize Grace Nicholson's disgust at being not only stolen but also traded by her own people. The poet used further animal imagery to describe herself and her effectrillion, traded like a fowl, like a goat, like a sack of kernels was once again. The imaged vocabulary emphasizes the horror of being inhumanness, devalued and traded like worthless goods, compared to a human life. The author uses another trillion to accentuate her feelings, traded, for beads, for pans, for train sets. We can also notice the first, and last, punctuation sign of the poem, an interrogation mark which emphasizes the author's disbelief and resentment. It also looks as if Grace Nichols is asking the reader to think about this, and as I read the poem I could almost hear her voice asking me, "Can you believe this?" The last two stanzas of the poem are much shorter, two lines each. And for the Irish time the reader is introduced to Grace Nichols of today, which brings her views in the actuality. Contradictory vocabulary is used, forget and remember. Think Grace Nichols is acknowledging that she has not come to term with her ancestral history, which she seems to have absorbed as her own, and the fact that she uses the word daily slash seems to indicate that she is still very much dealing with these issues to today's date. Daily I rinse the taint of treachery from my mouth. Grace Nichols has effectively uses numerous writing techniques in Taint to envoy her ideas and feelings to the reader. As a white reader, I felt uncomfortable reading this poem as if the guilt of my ancestors, the white tradesmen, was lying on my shoulder. Maybe this was intended by the author, who seemed to be, herself, carrying the suffering of her ancestors, the black slaves. Furthermore, it could be argued that Grace Nichols is stressing an issue that is still of actuality in some part of the world, and far from a selfish plea, I see in her words an appeal from all those that have suffered, still suffer and struggle to come to term with it.